Hi, in this video I will show how to install cartridge bottom bracket for square taper cranks and axles. And so we bought here what was available: Shimano Altus bottom bracket, about $11-12. Okay, and here it is, what it looks like. When you're doing this, I have an article on my website about bicycle chainline. I will explain, put a link to that in this video's description, but you need to be to pay attention to the length of the axle, because it needs to be appropriate for the chain line you're trying to achieve. And this also depends on the type of cranks that you're using. For Shimano, that we will be using here, it's usually 122.5 millimeters, and that's the bottom bracket that I have here. But I also have other lengths available at the ready, in case this doesn't turn out to be the good match. Sometimes you need a bit of mix matching depending on the frame and the particular cranks that you're using. So when I have an article about standards for this, and here this is a British standard, so the right hand side cup has the left hand sided thread, so you're screwing it in reverse. And when you're doing this, make sure that all the threads are clean, and I like to put some anti-seize paste to prevent things from getting stuck. So that's the first thing that I will do here. Just smear some anti-seize on the threads. I have cleaned them before this to make sure that everything is nice. I'll do it on the other side. Okay, looks good. This looks good. Now I will do the same for the cups, just to sleep better. It's not really necessary, but I prefer doing it that way. So for the left hand side cup, I'll put some of it. For the British standard, the cups get further tightened as you ride, they don't become unscrewed. So putting anti-seize paste will just help you in the long run, preventing them from being difficult to remove and replace later on. This inner part has some grease, so when you're screwing this in, it will nicely slide in and there's no need to do anything here. Okay, I will screw in the left hand side cup first, just by a few turns, to serve me as a sort of a guide. I'm doing this very gently, trying not to cross thread it, because the threads are very, very fine, and if I sense any kind of resistance or problems, I will stop, unscrew it, and see what the problem is and what's going on. Okay, this goes in smoothly. I don't want to go super tight here, just a few turns. Now for the right hand side cup. The right hand side cup is screwed in all the way. When you install it, this face needs to hit the frame. So this goes all the way in as far as it goes. You tighten it, and then you tighten the left hand side one as much as needed. Okay, here it is. I put some mounting paste on it as well, just in case. Now I'm sliding it in, catching the other end, and this one is British standard, so anti-clockwise for screwing in, and it goes in smoothly. Very good. Okay, the threads in the frame are very clean, and this goes nicely by hand. Okay, now it's the time to get the tools out. This is what I usually use for this. I have this tool for installing these cups, and I can use it like this. Okay, now I'm holding the frame to prevent it from taking much torque, and just tightening this. For British standard, I don't go crazy. I'm holding this almost halfway. this tool. I'm not using a lot of leverage. I want them to easily come out when it's time to replace them. I don't want to damage threads. Okay. I think this is more than tight enough. I'll do the same for the left-hand side one. The left-hand side has a standard thread, so I'm screwing it in clockwise. Okay. I'm pressing the tool to not come out with one hand, and I'm tightening it with the other. I can also do this while holding the frame. Not going crazy with the torque. Okay. I think this is good. I'm checking this, it should spin smoothly without any scratching, but it should not spin too freely. It should not be loose. Even if it has no play, it can be sometimes too loose, which means you haven't tightened it properly. It should be some resistance, but it should be smooth like butter. Okay, this looks good. Okay, so that's it. We've installed the cartridge bottom bracket, and now we can mount the cranks and see if we have got the chain line right. If this is too far out, then we won't be able to shift onto the largest chainring, and the chain will be at a great angle. And if it is too short, if the axle is too short, the crank might be hitting the chain stays. We need to get this just right. And before I mount this, I will clean this up a bit and put some anti-seize paste on this square tapered axle. Some people think that putting any kind of grease will do, but in my opinion, anti-seize gives a long-term protection from things seizing up and any galvanic corrosion, so it's a better option. And also, when it comes to square taper cranks, I've seen even some manufacturers recommend to fit this dryly without any sort of lubricant, and that is wrong because this system relies on preload, and to get any preload you need to get this high enough on the taper so that the preload is created. If any friction prevents it from going high enough, it will not fit nicely and it will become loose after a while and damage either cranks. If they're aluminium, if the crank is steel, then it will damage also the axle and the cranks, so that you can throw them away. So it's always a good idea to put some grease, even better to put some anti-seize when you're mounting this, and that will make sure it's seated properly and it doesn't become unscrewed. Some people fear that if they grease it, it will come too high and create too much tension to break this apart, to damage the cranks. That happens only if you ride the bicycle after mounting it for, like, say, 100 or 200 miles and then retighten the bolts. Because as you're riding, it moves away from the bolts pressure further up a bit. Those are fractions of a millimeter. And then as you retighten the bolt, it moves even further up, and that way you are going to damage it because you're using your whole body's weight and strength to push it up practically when the bolt is putting the pressure, because the bolt assemblies always go in the direction of the lower preload, lower pressure. A way to visualize that is to put some small parts of anything on a plate, then tilt it and rock it. They will start sliding as they're pulled by gravity. And the same principle goes for mechanics of bolt fasteners. I won't be discussing that any further. Now let's try to mount this one. The first thing that I will do here is to put this over to make it easier to mount the chain later. Now I'm using some anti-seize on this. All right. And I also put some on the crank just in case. It's usually enough to put anti-seize only on one surface as you're mounting something, but I sleep better doing it this way. And now I'll try to put it onto the axle. Okay, and now I'm checking out for this space between the crank and what's left of the axle. Here we have about 5 millimeters, and that should be enough with these Shimano cranks to create enough preload so they do not come loose. And I'm also turning it gently to see the chain line here, this part. I'm looking at this gap here between these two. When I screw this in, it will move some 5 millimeters further in, and here we have a bit more of a centimeter, so it should be enough that even when the frame is twisting and under torque as you're pedaling hard, this does not hit the chain stays. If this were not the case, I would need to dismount the bottom bracket and put one with the longer axle, but I think in this case it will work. Okay, now we have the bolts for mounting this, and I also want to lubricate with anti-seize this face of the bolt so there's no friction as I'm turning it to push the cranks further up. And I also want to lubricate the threads, of course. I don't want any friction playing part and fooling me, because when I put some mounting paste or grease, then all the torque that I use is used to create more preload and more pressure. So I want to have a more consistent reading. The amount of torque required to do this is, I would have to check it. I have no idea. It's about 12 to 15, maybe even 20 Newton meters. But I don't really care about that. I just use my sense with my hand how tight it is, and it works for me. But for those who are not experienced, use a torque wrench. Check the manufacturer specifications. If the manufacturer says that you need to use a dry fit, if they give a torque specification for a dry fit without any lubricant, anti-seize or anything, then when you're using anti-seize, reduce the recommended torque by some 20% roughly. If they don't mention anything, then you can check the new parts. Do they have some grease on it or not? Because cycling industry is very strange. It's not precisely given, but if you see that there's some grease on it from the factory, either on these splines, Shimano often put some grease on it, then you know, okay, that recommended torque is probably, most probably given for greasing or anti-seize, so you don't need to reduce the provided manufacturer specified tightening torque and just go. And so it's not very precise, and most often, so for me, using just the feel in my hands is good enough. I'm watching this slide over the axle. I would prefer for it not to bottom out against the end of the axle. It has like some sort of a stop on the right hand side, but I prefer to know that the widening of the taper has stopped it, not the, so that I know that there's enough preload. Okay, I think this is more than good enough. Just to double check. Okay, no need to do anything. Now just to confirm that it's not hitting the chain stays. Okay, this is perfect. As good as it gets. Alright, now we need to mount the left hand side crank, and I'm repeating the whole process basically, so I'll probably cut it out of the video. Okay, nice and clean. Put some here. And now when I'm mounting this, I want to make sure that they are opposite of each other, of course. I don't want to put it like this because it will be too fun to ride. We don't want that. A moderate amount of fun. All right, here we go. Okay, I'm checking this gap again. It's good if they are very similar on the left and right hand side, but you won't always get it exactly the same, especially not with every model of cranks and these axles, because cartridge bottom brackets cannot be finely tuned for the square taper at least. So sometimes you will have some mismatch in this space, but here these two are almost identical as much as I can tell, so that's perfect. Now we can install the pedals. Let's see. For the pedals, the right hand side one has the right hand side threads and the left hand side one has the left hand side threads. So it's screwed in anti-clockwise. I have an article explaining the threads also, the left and right hand side and how to easily tell the difference and know which direction you should be screwing in and out. And here I'm putting some anti-seize and I will screw it in. Making sure not to cross thread it. It's not going very smoothly. So I'll stop. Let's see about the left one. Right. This one is screwed in anti-clockwise. And this one goes in smoothly. Okay. And I want to double check this one to see what's going on. It looks okay. The threads don't look dirty. Let's give it another go. It's into the threads, it's not cross-threaded. There is some small amount of dirt preventing me from using my hand, but I'm not required to use any crazy torque here, so it's going to be all right. This frame is already scratched, but otherwise I would either have to put some sort of blank to hold the chain in place or put the wheel in or anything, so that when I turn this the chain doesn't scratch the frame. That's especially important for carbon fiber frames. You don't want that. Okay, I'm tightening it all the way. Okay, it's tight, it looks good. Now let's see about the left hand side one. This is the reverse direction. And when you have the wheels and everything in place, for screwing this in, you can just spin the pedals backwards and it will screw itself in. But in this case, I don't want to do too much scratching. I'm not holding on the pedal as I'm screwing it in because I don't want to risk cross-threading it. Okay, this is screwed in all the way. Let's double check. I don't want to go crazy on the torque, just to make sure it's tight. It's going in and out relatively smoothly, and this is good. Okay, we've installed the pedals. Not bad. So that's it. Thank you for watching and cheers.